Hello and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over some secrets on how to build an Excel dashboard in under 10 minutes.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
To give you an idea of where we're going in this video, I would like to show you the end product of the dashboard that we're creating today. We are going to create four graphs that have sales by category in the form of a bar chart, in the form of a line graph, the sum of sales by season, and also the average of sales by season. And these can be changed with the two slicers that we will create. So how do we go about doing that? So here I have a clothing spreadsheet for sales over the last four seasons. You can see that I have spring, summer, fall, and winter. And in each season, I have different categories and I have different prices for each item that has been sold. So what I would like to do is have a dashboard of all of this information where the user can see metrics really quickly. So what I'm going to do is hit this plus arrow down here and I get a new sheet. I'm going to double click on the sheet and write dashboard and hit enter. And this is where I'm going to put all of my dashboard information. I can click on this and drag it to the left of data. But let's go back to my data tab because that's where I'm going to do the bulk of my work. So if I click on data, up here, I am going to start my dashboard with a pivot table. So I'm going to go up here to insert and go to pivot table and do from table range. Right here, I'm going to click the up arrow and I'm just going to highlight columns A through D so I get this whole table of information in there. Then I'm going to click this again and say, okay. Over here, I'm going to select the season, the category, and the price. And I can see that my season will be listed and the categories will be listed underneath. And then the sum of the price for that category for that season is the number that is represented right here in column H. So I'm going to go ahead and close that. And then I'm going to click over here in J1 and just go up to insert, go over here to my graphs. And now I'm just going to select a 2D bar graph. Next, I'm going to right click on my chart and go to select data. And I'm going to hit this up arrow. And I'm just going to select this pivot table. And then I'm going to click this button again and then say, okay. So now with this chart, I can see my first part of my dashboard. I'm going to right click on here and go to cut and go back over here to my dashboard, right click and go to paste right here. And then I can resize this and I can see that the first part of my dashboard has a bar graph by season as well as by category.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So let's go back to my data tab. I'm going to come over here and now I'm going to insert another pivot table. So I'm going to go up to insert, go to pivot table, do from date range. Again, I'm going to hit the up arrow and select the same date range. Click this button again and say, okay. This time I'm going to pick season, category, and price. But the category down here, I would like to have in a column format. So I'm just going to click here, hold the mouse button down, and drag it up to columns. And then I'm going to close this. Next, I'm going to click down here and go up to insert and go over here to line graph and pick 2D line. Then I'm going to right click on here and go to select data, click the up arrow, select this pivot table, click this button again, and say okay. And now I can see that each of my different categories are represented on my line chart in different colors. It may be good to have a legend on this since I don't know what these colors mean. So if I keep the chart selected, I'm going to go up here to design, go over here to add chart element, go to legend, and stick this at the bottom. And now I can see what each one of these colors mean. Again, I'm going to right click and go to cut, go back to my dashboard, right click, and go to paste. And I can resize this and click and drag this to here. Now I might want to put a couple different titles on these charts. I can click here and then highlight and just do sales by season, by category. And over here I can do the same thing, sales by season, by category. It's just a different way to be looking at the same data. So next I'm going to go back to the data tab. And again, I'm going to click here and go to insert. And this time I'm going to pick a 2D column chart and I'm going to right click and go to select data, click the up arrow, pick this pivot table, hit this button again and say, okay. And then I'm going to right click and go to cut and go back to my dashboard and right click and go to paste. And then I'm going to select the title, highlight, and say sum of sales by season. And I can move this over here, make it a little bit smaller, and have this on the right side of the page. And then finally, I'm going to go back to data and go to insert. And I want to insert one more pivot table. And again, I'm going to click the up arrow, select this date range, click the button again and say, okay. And this time I'm going to put season in the rows, category in the columns, and price in the values. But I'm going to click on this arrow here and go to value field settings. And I'm going to select average and say, okay, and close this window. And then I'm going to click here and go to insert another 2D column, right click, go to select data, hit the up arrow. And this time I'm going to pick this pivot table right here. Click this button again, say, okay, right click, go to cut. Go back to dashboard, right click, go to paste. And this time I'm going to click the title and change it to average of sales by season. And then I'm going to make this a little bit smaller and click and drag over here. Now, one thing you might notice on all of these graphs is I have a blank here, a blank here, a blank here, and a blank here. And this is taking up a lot of my space. So if I go back over here to data, and I click on my pivot table. So I'm just going to click this down arrow here and deselect the blank option and say, okay. And I can see that that blank goes away. Same with this row label. I'm going to click the down arrow, deselect blank, say, okay, and click the down arrow and deselect blank and say, okay. So now if I go back to my dashboard, I can see that that blank has been taken out of every one of my graphs. And so let's just click this one and make it a little bit smaller and make this one a little bit wider. Now for the final thing on our dashboard, I'm going to select this graph and go up to insert and go over here to slicer. And I'm going to pick the item category that I wish to see in each of these graphs. And I'm going to say, okay. So now this slicer has a list of all of my different categories. So if I click on this button, I will allow a multi-select so I can see more than one category on this graph over here. So if I go in here and deselect all of these, I can see that there's no data on my graph. Now I can pick each category individually. I can see tops, I can see tops and bottoms, and see how my sales are going, or I can select all of them again. And I can see that this slicer is only changing this graph over here. But what if I would like it to change all of my graphs at the same time? I'm going to right click on the slicer and go to report connections. And I'm going to select here, if I click and make this taller for you, you can see my other pivot tables. I'm going to select all of the pivot tables that I have inside of this workbook and say, okay. So now when I select and deselect on here, I can see that all of my graphs are changing. So if I just want to know the status of outerwear, I can see this is outerwear. This is my sales by season, my average sales by season, and also the amount of money that I've sold in each category over here. And then I can compare that with accessories or all of my data if I would like. I can just make it a little bit smaller and keep it at the top of my graph. if I would like to, I can also select this graph and go up to insert and go over here to slicer and pick a slicer by season as well and say, okay. And I'm going to move this one, just resize it next to the existing one and turn on the multi-select. So now I can see all seasons right now. I can deselect fall. I can deselect winter and just see my spring and summer amounts. But notice it's only changing this graph. So again, I have to right click on here and go to report connections and connect this to my other two pivot tables and say, okay. And now I can see whatever I select in here. So these two slicers actually work together. If I wanted to, I could just see spring and summer and outerwear. So whatever combination I select here will be reflected on the graphs that we have created. So hopefully that shows you how you can make a dashboard like this in less than 10 minutes. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. As always, thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.